Hi guys, my name is Slamba. So today we'll be doing question 31 on page 290. It reads as follows. In order to compare two treatments, a matched pairs experiment was performed on 12 pairs of subjects. The paired differences, that is the difference in response, treatment A minus treatment B, were recorded. So we were given the differences. So the question is there a significant difference in the treatment? Test at the 1% level of significance. So since we are given the difference, we should find the mean difference. And we should find the standard deviation of the difference. Then alpha, which is 0.01, we were given. So just press these values in your calculator, then find the mean and the standard deviation. So the mean was 5.25. Then the standard deviation was 9.7991. So we have to test the significance, if there is a significant difference in the treatment. So the first thing we should do is the hypothesis, which is to define H0 and H1. So H0, the mean difference should be 0. The mu difference, actually, look at the mu difference. So here it should not be 0. Because we want to test if there is a difference. Then number two is the test statistic, where we have to define, like write the formula that we are going to use. So in terms of this difference thing, where the variations, where they are dependent on each other. Or the two things are dependent, yeah. Two events.
Samples.
Two samples. But it's the same thing, events, samples. Okay, they are dependent on each other. So the formula we use is T equal to the mean difference minus the mu difference divided by the standard deviation over square root of n, where t is n minus 1. Then number 3, we determine the rejection region. So the rejection region is always the H0, we always reject the H0. We reject the H0 if H0 is not equal to 0. So then, because it has to be a negative, because if it's not 0, it's either a negative or a positive. So we use this sign. Then we say, reject H0 if T observed, yeah. Here the T observed is greater than the T n minus 1, then alpha divided by 2, which is the same as T11. Then 0.01 divided by 2 is 0.005, which gives us the value of 3.106 from the T table. I think that's table 3. If you go to the degrees of difference of 11, then you go to 0.005 probability, you'll find the value. Then number four is calculations, where we calculate this t observed. So t observed, here is the formula that you are going to use. That means it's the mean difference, which is 5.25. We subtract this one, which is the one we are using here, the mu difference, which is 0. We divide by the standard deviation of 9.7991, divide by the square root of n. Then our n, here we said n minus 1 is 11, that means our n is 12. We've got 12 values of difference. Then this gives us, from the calculator, 1.8559. And now we have to calculate the p-value. Which is equal to 2p. We are saying 2p because we are solving the two things, greater and less, because it's not equal to 0, so it's greater or less. That's why it's 2p into t being greater than the t observed. That means it's 3.106. So we have to solve for this thing now. So the best thing we can do is to divide by 2 first, so that we remain with only the probability of t being greater than 3.061, which is 1 over 2 now, because here it was 1 p-value, so we divide it by 2.
T observed, isn't it supposed to be the 1.8559,
not the... Oh yeah, you're right. You. It should be 1.86.
You use your T observed, 1.8559.
Oh, I had someone saying 6, so... So this is 1 over 2 p value equals to the probability of t being greater than 1.8559. So if we check our t table, we can see that there is no value of 1.85559. But then we can check where it lies, which two values does it lie between. So here we found out that it lies between the probability of t being greater than 2.201 and 1.179. So on the table, as the values increase, the probability decrease. So as the values increase, then the probability decrease. Hence we're gonna say the probability of t being greater than 2.201 is less than the probability of t being greater than 1.8559, which is less than the probability of t being greater than 1.796. So the reason why we have a bigger number here and a smaller number here is because as the numbers increase, the probability decrease. So here we want the probability of this whole thing and the probability of this whole thing. So we know that the probability of this is less than the probability of this because the numbers are increasing now. So we're gonna have the probability of of t being greater than 201, which is 0.025, which is less than. So this one, the probability of t being greater than 1.8559, we said it's 1 over 2 p value. So we can substitute it by 1 over 2 p value here. Which is less than the probability of that one, which is 0.05. So now, because what we are solving is the p value, we have to divide by both sides by 1 over 2 to get the p value. Then it's going to be 0.05 less than p value now. Less than, then 0.05 divided by 1 over 2, which is
0.5.
Yeah,
sorry, I think it should be
0.1. Oh, 0.1. So then now we have to conclude that step 6 of the hypothesis. So we conclude looking at the condition that we made and also the p value compared to the alpha. So first we'll say, since the t observed, which is 1.8559, we said what? We said it should be greater than t n minus 1 alpha divided by 2, which is 3.106. to cancel this one now, so it's not greater than it. And the p value less than alpha. So our p value is this one. It lies between 0.1 and 0.05, which is less than alpha. Then we can see that it's this thing is not less than this thing. Right? Then we have to also cancel this thing. So since we canceled these two, we come here and do this because we met the condition, right? So then we didn't meet the condition, so we failed to do what we said. So that means we fail to reject H naught. And conclude that at 1% level of significance, there is insufficient evidence to conclude that there is a significant difference. Yeah, that's it.